What do you mean?
Wild man. What kind of wild man?
Like that, I reckon. Well, if that's how you feel, why don't you earn yourself 20 quid and fight him?
Oh, I think I will.
Anyway, what about the evil eye?
Oh, that kind of thing doesn't worry me. My wife's got two of them.
Station of some type. What the hell's going on here? Ah, my good man. Yeah, you're right, upstanding, fine, sitting down sort of person you are too. Would you be interested in buying a little array of apothecary's remedies at all? Here, would you like a couple of these? You don't appear to have any at the moment. Would you like some of this? This actually is a remedy which I can find only to myself. The top of the morning to you. Now then. Are you interested in any of these things? I'm not asking a lot of money. You appear to be some manner of idiot, my friend. Would you get out of the way then if you're not going to buy anything? You might be interested in a little device here I have. This is a remedy for people who won't get out of the bloody way. Would you like to try it? Just tip your head a little to the side.
He can't hear you.
What? Ah, you're deaf, are you? Right then. Can you people hear me at all?
Yeah, we can hear
right
you
then.
All right.
What have you got to say? Good day to you, my friend. Well, I might say it's a fine looking afternoon and all it is. By God, you're not looking well. You're a very seriously ill looking group of people. Now then, this, sir, unless I'm much mistaken, you are a bald man. Take your hat off. dear, suffering Jesus, put your hat on again. I can't bear it. You can't go about like that with the baldness, my friend. You're going to need some of this. I make it up personally in my own laboratory. Now, this will cure your head of the dreaded baldness. Am I asking a pound? Am I asking 10 shillings? Am I asking a guinea? I am asking a florin, sir. Merely a florin. Of course, it won't put hairs on your head straight away. You'll have to wait till the morning, when I, unfortunately, will be here no longer. Save the Lord. Now then, just, I'll do better than tell you about it, my friend. I'll show you. Try some of that. Just try it. Aye. Now then, my friend, I have here a remedy for the voided dance and sundry madness. Look at this little beauty. 75% wool, not to be taken internally. Now come here, my man. The poor man. He's bald.
Bald?
I'm not bald. We'll fix just a little bit. But I'll fix it, I tell you. I'll fix it.
I'll get rid of the bald.
I'm good.
His name was Beth. A mad gorilla smashed the door down, beat them
night.
Jawbone, not since King Henry VIII slept the night alone, not since the foreman picked up a shovel and did an honest day's work, has a creature such as I present to you today come before the horrified gaze of an honest and fearful public. Captured at terrible cost in blood, gold and human sanity. Restrained by the miracles of the blacksmith's art. Dragged by elephants from the steaming tropical jungle, I bring you here today, and gone tomorrow, an object of terror and amazement. Shut up, Luke. And so, ladies and gentlemen, for your edification, education, and for some, perhaps, the most exciting cathartical experience of your lifetime, I present to you the Wild Man from Borneo! Come on, Ruby, let's go!
Sweetheart, then.
Oh, wild, is he?
Need some exercise, I think.
That's all right.
Bloody amateurs.
Didn't say that after Jackson.
Jackson's was Jackson's and Fox's is Fox's.
Oh. Tough towns make good pickings.
They tar and feathered the half man, half woman when they caught him half up the harbour master's half sister.
I can do it.
It remains to be seen.
Yeah, so does the money.
You'll see it.
Yeah. 6 months takings and off to Sydney town.
Don't come in here shouting things you can't afford.
Every night.
Oh.
What about all her children at home?
Like the new number?
What happened to the old one?
Don't you remember when I ripped the crutch out at Cronin?
Bring it here.
What? Oh.
Turn around.
Ah! Oh, look what you've done.
Part of the makeup, isn't it?
Watch him closely, ladies and gentlemen. Beware the evil eye. Remember, he's nothing but an animal. Nothing but a bloody animal.
You, Willie Masters. They're still talking about the Jacksons fight down there in Jackson.
Jackson? It's good.
Aye. But Willie Masters is better. No, don't deny it. Willie Masters, champ of the coast. The man to beat the wild man. And any man who disagrees, disagrees with Morgan.
He's good, all right.
I'm not denying he's not a tough nut. There, son, I'm talking to you. I'm not denying he's not a tough nut.
What about the evil eye?
I saw him take on Dewey McGee down there in Okatika. And if they hadn't dragged him clear, he'd have eaten him where he lay. But Dewey McGee's not Willie Masters. And if any man can beat the wild man and get the 20 quid, it's Willie Masters.
What's in it for you?
Oh, the wild man did that. Myself, I know you've got a weak ticker. But I just want the satisfaction of settling an old score.
Right, let's take it from the top. Try it again.
What about the nose you give me in Collingwood?
Fell off in the second round.
Yeah. You sort of horrified the vicar's wife, huh?
It wasn't the nose. Well, I don't know. Stop chewing.
Staying on.
45, 46, 47.
Oi! Got enough. The evil eye. Have a look at this.
Hey, a bit of pace. Only 5 more miles to go.
Cubs are hungry. The she-wolf will steal the cuckoo's egg, my son. Traveller to the Duke Hotel. It's all right, he's only an idiot. Get up. Up, Romy. Jump up behind. Two idiots are better than one. Thank you.
dirty wild man on a Cuffer's loincloth.
There's a man in Jackson, sir, very sorry for a remark like that.
Is a half man, half woman, halfway to Nelson, still trying to get the tar out of his whiskers?
We no call for tar and feathers in this case, my good man.
Just as well, men, we'd have to send a grave for enough tar to cover you.
Yeah, bad time.
Wrong, sir! You and all these good people will pay on Saturday night at Gilly's Cave. Adults, 1 shilling. Children, 2 pence. And now, for all the law-abiding citizens of the town, to show my good faith, a drink in yonder hostelry. Follow me! Recorded words, sir, of George Jackson of Jackson's. You said very little since.
Let's see your money where your mouth is. Let's up the ante, do 30 quid?
I'll accept a wager from any man.
But how do I know you'll pay your debts?
I choose to ignore the insulting nature of those remarks, sir. The barman will take care of it, won't you, sir?
Sure we will.
Then here's 10 quid, sir. And there's me.
I'd rather have the 10 quid. But I'll accept both. And I'll accept the wager from any man present.
Yeah, look, I put 10 quids worth of this stuff on our Jake. You and Jake.
No.
We'll see about that on Saturday night, won't we, sir?
Yeah, we'll see.
Well, gentlemen, I must away and get some raw flesh for the wild man's dinner. See you all on Saturday.
53 pounds, heaven and sex.
Thank you.
Put it down.
Aye,
I leave him be. We can use him.
He can't even talk. Hey, talk. Speak. Come on.
Can he hear?
Good ears. You're doing, idiot! Put it down!
Thank you.
Bollinger 88.
Where'd you get that?
Whipped it out of a bag while you were bashing that beachcomber at the 12 mile fight.
What else did you get? Apart from a cold ass and no Russians.
Yeah, just the boots and that deep one.
Deep one.
Well, what else was there? Don't mind if I have a drink. Been saving this one up for the end.
We're not finished yet.
Yeah, but tomorrow's the last one, isn't it?
The last one.
Yeah. Then we hit Sydney Town. Imagine Sydney with 500... down in our pockets.
You wouldn't know what to do with it.
Listen, mate, up till now, I've had to win the ladies relying on the evil eye. Not anymore.
Never again.
It's only the beginning. After Sydney, the mysterious East. London. Festivals in France. Raving in Rio.
Plastered in Paris.
America! It's empty.
Yeah.
I'm doing a good job.
Now, ladies, may I point out to you the fierce aspect of the wild man? Please stand back just a little. Thank you very much. It doesn't pay to get too close to him, you understand. He may appear to be... Get away from there! He may appear to be tamed, but I assure you this is just the appearance. He is, in fact, a dangerous and vicious brute, not to be tampered with under any circumstances. Wild man escaped just south of Christchurch. It took us 3 weeks to recapture him. In that time, he fathered 15 children, had 27 sheep, and felled the Vicar of Wakefield.
He's a wild man.
He's no wild man. I bet you he's no wild man.
He's wilder than you, my friend.
You want to have a go at him?
Yeah, yeah.
Come this way.
No, don't get it!
If you get him drunk, the tar and feathers will be for you.
Human flesh!
Come on!
on, man. Get on with it, man.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, wild man.
Wild man speaks no English, nor does he have any concept of fair play. I have said this many times, but it cannot be too often repeated. Beware the evil eye. Anyone who looks upon the evil eye risks a life of madness.
Look, 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 look
for one.
Get me rope.
It's too small.
Crazy bastard.
It's a rope.
You big. It'll do for the colonel's neck. Take it right off his fat shoulder. Get me up, you steady lefter. I'll give you your liver at me. Get the rope up here. Put a knot in it.
Saw what happened. I said all along the wild man was invincible.
Don't know how you did it, Colonel, but cheat he did. This is your just reward.
We're nobody hanging from that rope tonight. Now, what are we all standing around here talking for? There's beer to be drunk. Beat up the money, partner. Thank you very much.
Well,
shout! Come on! You're leaving already, Morgan? Aren't you going to stay for the fun?
He's upstairs changing.
Oh, go get up. Come back! Zombie!